every good meal should begin close to home. But sometimes, the connection is lost when food travels more than 1,500 miles before getting to the local grocery store. Alisa Smith and J.B. MacKinnon began thinking about this conundrum, especially in light of climate change, after the time at their remote cabin when they and their guests had to assemble a dinner made solely from the fish and plants found nearby. Back in Vancouver, they vowed to spend an entire year living on food that originated within 100 miles of home. They recorded their ups and downs in a blog. The blog grew into an online column, and the column became a book, The 100 Mile Diet, a year of local eating. And did it ever strike a chord with like-minded locavores? Hundreds of speaking engagements and interviews inspired 100 Mile Dieters who flocked to farmers markets in small towns and big cities. Where there wasn't a farmers market, like in Alliance, Ohio, the people started one. The world was ready. The book would go on to earn a BC Book Prize and spawn a TV series. Alisa Smith demonstrates what can happen when individuals take responsibility for their food choices and the sense of control and the community building that comes from following a dream and sticking with solid principles.